You've got JSON data. Maybe you got it from an API. Maybe you got it from a file. How do you parse it? How do you make sure it's valid? And how do you convert all the data types? Sounds complicated. With Pydantic, it's easy, and we're going to see how in this video. Let's imagine you're a motorcycle enthusiast. You love to go riding. So you get a job at a company like Revver, building apps where people can record and upload and share their rides. Chances are a lot of this is being exchanged as JSON data. Maybe your job is to integrate with some partners so that they can upload this data. Well, how do you know it's going to be accurate? How do you know what you said your API needs is actually what you've received? Sure, you could do that by hand, but we're going to see that with Pydantic, a cool new Python library, we can make this very much automatic. And at the same time, our editor will actually help us write better code because Pydantic uses Python types. Let's jump over here to PyCharm and fire it up. So we have some data. This is some sample data that might be submitted for a user over in some kind of app like our Revver app. So let's go create an app and we'll just call it receive data. And we're not going to talk about loading this data just yet. We're just going to come up here and put it into our code. Normally you would get this from an API, as I said. So we want to parse this data. Now, if we look at it, there's a couple of things that maybe will stand out to you. For example, there's an age, 28. Who doesn't want to be 28, right? Now that's a number, except for it's actually a string here. It might look like a number, but it's technically the data type of string, and Python is going to treat it super differently. We've got our location. Do we need to specify the country? I don't remember. And down here we have rides, like maybe these are recorded rides and just the index of them. Well, that one, what was that? Who typed that in? That was weird. So there's some problems with this data. We would need to validate all those types of things. But it also turns out it's probably okay, right? We could see that, well, that really just needs to be parsed as an integer. And same for that other piece there. How do we deal with this? Let's go and create a class. We'll call this user. And in here, we want to give it basically the information that represents this data. So it's going to be a name. And in Python, we can say this is a string like this. And it's going to have a location. We have no idea what the location is going to be. This is another class. We'll deal with that in a second. We have a bike, which is going to be a string. And we have rides, which is a list of int. These are all great. And maybe if you don't have any rides, we'll even set it to be empty like this. Now, let's work on that location real quick. We'll have a location. We spell it right. And it's going to have a city, which is a string. It's going to have a state, which is a string. And it's going to have a country, which is a string. Although we didn't get that, did we? This is a cool way to define classes in Python, but it doesn't allow us to do that validation. Here we can actually be a little more specific. It doesn't allow us to do any sort of parsing and validation. It just, when we program against it, lets us work with these types, right? For example, if we have a user and we say u.rides. You can see we get all the list stuff. That's great. But we want to use Pydantic. How do we do that? First thing we have to do is install it. We have a virtual environment active. Actually, let's put it in the requirements file first. I'm going to put it over here into this requirements file so we can pip install -r requirements like that. Wait a moment, and now we have Pydantic. So up here, what we're going to say is that this is a base model. Now this comes out of Pydantic, finish parsing things, and say we need to import this up at the top here. And the same thing right there. Now when we do that, we're going to be able to come down here and say, well, now that we have this data and we have this user, we're going to be able to say user and just pass in the data by keyword argument. And in Python, we do that by saying *, a dictionary that turns it into things like name equals Michael and so on. So we'll say *, data like that. Now this is not really going to work out because this says the country is required and the country is missing. But let's go ahead and give it a try and find out what's happened. So we're going to go run this. Look at this. We don't just get some kind of error saying data is missing. No, we get specific errors like the location's country is missing. How cool is that? Well, one thing we can do is we could set this to have a default value. And then it works because it's missing, but there's a default, so we'll just use the default. The other thing we could do here is we could say the country is actually optional. This is a Python type thing, but Pydantic reads that and says, well, if it's optional, it doesn't have to be there, but if it is there, it has to be a string. So now, again, it runs. Let's go ahead and print out this. Like so. We found a user, Michael, location, look at this. City is Portland, state is Oregon, country, none. The bike down here is a KTM. Wait a minute, check this out. Look at that 70. Remember, the 70 was busted. The 70 was in quotes. But Pydantic said, you know what? Yes, it is a string, but it's parsable to the data type that we actually said, which what we said was a list of integers. So it saw strings that I can make that an integer successfully. So it tried and succeeded. Same thing for the age. If we would actually remember to put that on our user, let's say age is an int, and we run it again. Now our age also gets parsed over. So cool. So here's the story. If we have invalid data or missing data, we get meaningful errors. Like we put this here, it'll say, you know what? The age is not a valid integer, right? If it's parsable to an integer, we're good to go. But if it's not, then Pydantic will give us meaningful errors. So all we have to do in order to work with Pydantic is have some JSON data, create a class, and these can nest together as we see here. And if we put none, that should probably be optional. But we put in the types, the fields and the types, including the nesting, including stuff within lists and so on. And then we just load up the data by keyword argument. The easiest way is to say star star dictionary, and it parses it, converts it, validates it, and then we have a class that we can work with, like user.rides, and that we know this is a valid list of integers. Fantastic. That was simple, wasn't it? Incredibly easy to use Pydantic to parse and validate data that we get from other locations in any JSON format as a Python dictionary, effectively. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click on my face up there and subscribe to the channel. Also, like this video. It really helps support our work. I actually interviewed the creator of Pydantic over on Talk Python to Me. So check out the podcast episode there. And we have a whole class on Fast API and Pydantic at Talk Python Training. So many more things to explore if this got you interested in Pydantic. Thanks for watching. Catch you next time.